So, I guess Paul's back, or at least sort of. Something is definitely wrong. He seems agitated and not himself, really. Or maybe I'm just mad. I didn't think anybody was really watching these videos, only to come in this morning and find my little montage plastered all over the lab. At least it didn't make it onto the internet. Great.
Lambda functions. Lambda functions. I have no evidence that they're helpful, but I'm going to integrate them into tools used worldwide anyway.
Huh?
Empirical evidence doesn't matter. Syntax doesn't matter. Type system design doesn't matter. I believe it firmly without any evidence.
Seriously? I'm worried. But Dr. Day tells me if I don't finish up some actual biology programming today, I might not be able to keep my job. So I'm gonna do my work and try to ignore it. Today we're investigating biological organisms and having them compete in the computer for survival. Or sort of, at least. Day wants me to get back on track, vlogging about actions. Since this type of work uses them, like before, I'm going to make an extra project in Quorum offline, just in case others in the lab want to experiment. Okay, actions. It says here in the notes that Dr. Day gave me that we start by realizing we've been doing actions all along. Apparently, oh, hey, neat. Quorum automatically makes one for you, behind the scenes, called main, which it does to make it easier for beginners. If I want to run a program that uses actions explicitly, then what the? Ignore it, Mary. Keep your job. Talk about basic programming ideas like actions. When we have a main action, we can do anything we did previously inside of it. We can use the repeaty thingy, or if thingy, or variables, or whatever. But what's really cool is that we can now write other actions and then call them. Let's try it. Now, with actions in Quorum, the convention is to capitalize the first letter of their name. I'm going to write two actions, one named main, by typing action main with a capital M. Which I have to have because that's where my program will always begin executing. Every action needs to have an end to it, so I'll type that now as well. The next action I'll name test by typing action test with a capital T and give it an end as well. So on the screen we have action main with a capital M and then end, and then we have action test with a capital T and end. Now I'm going to make three output statements to make sure my program calls the test action. Inside of the action main, I'm going to write an output statement to output the word before, and another to output the word after. Between those output lines, I'm going to write the word test, with a capital T, so it knows to refer to our action named test, and then two parens at the end of it, a left paren and a right paren. The reason we do this is so the program knows to call our test action and execute the code inside of it. Lastly, we're going to write an output statement in our test action to output the phrase test message. If we run this code, what we should see is the word before, then test message, and finally the word after. It should be in that order because the action main is called first when my program loads. From there, it will output the word before, like normal, and then when the action test is called, it outputs test message. And then, finally, execution jumps back to the main, which then outputs the word after. I have to admit, actions are a little tricky. However, Day says they're an important concept in programming that everybody uses, so learning them is worth the effort. I guess that means I'd better get to designing my super bug tester. I'll post that code in my notes so others in the lab can download it if they want to explore it more in Quorum's offline mode.